We're back, and you're watching News Channel 3 Live at 9. A Memphis woman turns tragedy into triumph and now uses that victory to make a difference for other families like hers right here in Memphis.
Such a great story. Crystal DeBerry is founder of Indomitable Women, an organization that really started, Crystal, out of your own situation.
Yes.
First, tell us what the group does, what you strive to do with the group.
Okay, so Indomitable Women, what we strive to do is just help families affected by incarceration. We started off primarily just assisting women, wives, you know, mothers, girlfriends, aunts, daughters, and just supporting any woman that has gone through this trauma. It seems common, okay.
Right.
You know, it just seems like we know someone who's gone to, you know, jail or prison, but people, I don't think people realize the crisis that a loved one faces on a daily basis.
Right, it can create a whole eruption in the family system through no fault of their own.
You both mentioned your own situation. What was it? What prompted all of this?
Okay, so here I am. My husband is, at the time, he was actually not my husband. We were dating, talking about marriage, and, you know, we get a knock at the door. It's the feds and a lot of other men coming to get him, and I'm thinking, what in the world is going on? You know, and so with that experience there, it was a matter of, what am I supposed to do with this? Here I am, master's degree, social work, providing therapy, but I'm in love with someone who's a convicted felon.
You wanted to leave, didn't you?
Yes. You know, I prayed about it. You know, God, what do I do with this? You know, and it was just a matter of, you're staying, but in what capacity? I was okay with just being friends. But again, we had talked about marriage. This was something serious, you know, and so it was a matter of, no, you're going to stay. During his trial, we married. We married while he was going through the trial process. Ended up getting pregnant. I'm sitting in court as he's being sentenced with a five-day-old baby. This is my third child. And I'm thinking, what am I going to do with this? What do I do with this? And so I realized at that moment while I was sitting in court, I couldn't cry. And it was either a matter of my body was tired from having a baby 5 days prior, or I realized here I am now, three children by myself, lost income. I had to do something. I ended up getting a job for every child I had, you know, and it was just a matter of, but I had that career to fall on.
Right.
Other women like me, they don't have those resources in regards to just the profession maybe, or even just the resources in the city to help them while they're going through this crisis.
So you mentioned you started the organization to help women like yourselves, but you've sort of, well, God's changed it for you a little bit, right?
Yes.
You recently, through Providence, bought a house that needs work.
Yes.
Who's going to do the work, and why is that project so important?
So at this point, we are looking into changing the mission statement, because we're moving from women to the men and even the youth of the city now. So just to start with the men.
The returning.
The returning citizens, yes. Those that are returning from prison and jail. We're going to pay them a stipend to remodel blighted homes. So our first home is in Orange Mound off Roselle. So we're very excited about that. We lucked up on that house. It was a company from Washington, the state, who owned it and, you know, and sold it to us for little to nothing. Very blessed to have that opportunity.
And it'll give them skills, the
men. Yes, because it's a 20-week clinical program addressing mental health. Myself, as well as my board of directors, we're licensed clinical social workers. Our psychologist that's in Nashville sits on the board. We just come from that clinical standpoint, and we also have a retired MPD.
Wow.
On the board.
This has grown so much just in what, the past two, almost 3 years now.
Yes.
Are you even a bit surprised by the impact of what you're doing?
Yes. I would have never imagined doing this with my social work career. Never imagined this. My background, I loved working with children, and I battled with that. Like, wait a minute, here I am working with this population here, but when, you know, God tells you to do something, you have to move.
Why is it important to everyone in the community that this succeeds?
Because crime is everywhere. I feel like we've all been victims. It didn't feel good. So we have to give back, you know, in some way, shape, form, or fashion. So again, the 20-week clinical program for these men, again, they will receive a stipend. as well as the clinical and mental health component,
right,
to just help with them.
And the construction skills, right, they
yes,
can turn
and
into
the
a long-term job.
Correct, yes.
Well, we appreciate you being here. What an incredible
you.
Story.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
And you've seen on the screen how
That's
you
it.
Can help out by coming
Thank
out
you, Crystal.
And supporting.
Thank you.
Thank
Good
you
to have
so
you
much, Crystal.
Thank you.